areas of India that have the greatest forest cover and the most mineral wealth are also its poorest. Local communities use forests to meet their livelihood needs. On the other, several global and national priorities have compelled the use of forests for the production of timber or other industrially valuable forest products to meet the demands of rapid economic growth through the creation of industrial estates, port complexes, energy projects and transport infrastructure, for the conservation of wildlife and for carbon sequestration. This conflict, as we have seen, has played out in some of the most impoverished regions of India and impacted the lives of India's most vulnerable people.
As I said, the forested landscape is a place of conflict or tension between at least three, four different objectives. Forests for whom and for what? Forests for the meeting local livelihood needs. Forests for, say, wildlife conservation and in the modern era now, carbon sequestration. Or forests as a source of land which is actually meant for development. So, forests for conversion into mining or dams and so on and so forth. And of course, forests as a source of industrial raw materials. So, there are these four objectives that are in a sense pulling in different ways in terms of how forests should be managed, that will change the physical nature of the forest, change the distribution of benefits from that forest, whether the benefits go to local communities, to industry or to the nation, national state, or will remain in sort of in the intangible form of wildlife benefits and so on and so forth. So, we are talking about a tension between these four objectives, and the way the tension is resolved is very, very complicated and messy in the Indian law.
Who and what are forests for? And how do we make these decisions? This is also a broad statement of the central problem in the governance of forests.